The secret of golf. Want to know? Simple. It's shaft stress. It feels to us like it's happening like this as we go through the ball, but it's not. At the top, it's stressed. The shaft is stressed like this, and that puts a, and it's stressed by the lower body leading and the upper body lagging. That shaft stress puts a stress right here in this right index finger. We call it the number three pressure point. And as long as that stress is maintained in the shaft, it maintains that pressure. Or you could say it vice versa. As long as you maintain that pressure, you maintain the stress in the shaft. Now, an interesting thing is that stress is coming from the sweet spot to this point. And the shaft can't keep up with that straight line pull, so it actually comes into the ball this way. And that's kind of an interesting phenomenon that we're just now seeing in some of these modern day layouts that you see in Golf Digest, Golf World. But this pressure is still in line with that forefinger, and it's going right down in that straight orange line to the sweet spot of the club. So we're all about club head lag and maintaining that. Most of you guys get to the top, there may be some initial stress, but a lot of times they're not even that. It's this. You absolutely, not only do you not stress it and bring that stress shaft into impact, you are throwing it away. So how do we stop doing that? What is the correct feel of club head lag, pressure point pressure? You know, Jones wrote years ago that the pull from the top, you could only pull against your own muscles, the tension in your own muscles. Well, for perhaps this only time, Mr. Jones got it wrong. What you're pulling against is not your own muscles, you're pulling against Mother Nature. This sweet spot does not want to go along with you. Sir Isaac Newton taught us that a body at rest wants to stay at rest unless it's acted on by an outside force. Well, the outside force we have here is the body is pulling the arms pulling the hands pulling the club, and that sweet spot is trailing along behind that. At any point in time, it wants to stop doing that, but is being led into impact with the hands leading, club lagging. What is the correct feel? If it's not this convulsive throwing pressure, then what is it? This is where the rubber meets the road, guys. Get a mop, and not a little mop. Get a big mop, and not a broom. What did I say? I said a mop, I said a big mop, and I said not a broom. Then a big pail of water, and get it wet. So you take this big old mop, get it all nice and wet, sit it down, see those tentacles stretched out behind you, grab a nice hole in a golf grip, put the shaft in line with this left forearm, and with your body, you get firm here. This is a big old heavy wet mop, and your head centered, using the core muscles of your body, not just your arms here, begin to pull or drag that wet mop through impact. Drag that wet mop. The camera could come in close and look at that right index finger and look at the stress that's on that forefinger. Drag that wet mop. That wet mop is so big and so heavy, there's no way I could throw it anyway. But this is what you guys are doing with that little club head. It only weighs 5 ounces. Try it with this puppy. You're not going to flip this one through. Whoa, bang. This is what a great champion feels through impact, and this is how they look through impact. This is what we do. This is what we feel through impact. And this is what we look like through impact. There's a big difference. Club head lag, pressure point pressure. It's the secret of golf.